Our next guest was days away from giving birth when the unthinkable happened.
Woke up, normal day, and I was really excited because it was one of my last prenatal visits. You know, the doctor said it'll be within days. I was just leaving the doctor's office, and we were struck by a drunk driver.
911, the address of your emergency.
We just experienced a car crash over at 17th and Pace. Two cars.
I'm reporting a driver in a gold Durango. He's got one flat tire in the back, and the front tire is like the wheel is falling off, but he's driving down the street just totally erratically.
And I lost Brady. It was really hard because someone took him from me. Everybody else got to see Brady, and I made the choice not to see him because I wanted to remember him the way he was. When he would kick, when he had the hiccups, even the heartburn, I wanted to remember that instead of seeing him like that, because I knew that that wasn't him anymore. The law says that Brady wasn't a person. Brady was 8 pounds, 2 ounces. Brady was a person. His life was worth defending.
Sorry. Heather is here with her mother, Terry. And first off, Heather, thank you for so bravely talking about this, because I know this is still really fresh for you. I want to go back to that day. You just left your prenatal visit. When did you find out that Brady had died?
Once the accident had happened, I had gotten out of my car and I had really bad back pain. And I went to go check on my son. He was 5 and, you know, in the back seat, and then my mom was in the passenger side. So I checked on them. The next thing I remember is waking up in ICU. I had a breathing tube in. I couldn't talk. I couldn't ask questions. My mom and my dad and my sister were in the, they came into the ICU room where I was. And my dad was crying, and my dad never cries. And I knew something was wrong. And that's when they looked at me and they said, Brady was killed in the accident.
We're so very sorry. And Dr. Ashton, I think a lot of people may not realize how susceptible an unborn child is.
Yeah.
Even in a seemingly minor accident in some cases.
Well, I mean, absolutely. There can be significant fetal trauma. There can be significant maternal trauma. There can be both. We have to remember every pregnant woman is at least 2 lives. In the case of you, definitely 2 lives. And in a car accident where there's a sudden jolt, externally, you can appear fine, but the placenta can dislodge from the surface of the uterus. That is the baby's entire blood supply. We call it a placental abruption, and it can cause death in the fetus in minutes, including tremendous blood loss and put your life in danger also. And you know, obstetrically, the data is crystal clear. At about 24 weeks, give or take a couple of weeks, that fetus is considered viable, which means it can survive outside the mother. Certainly when you're at the end of your pregnancy, that's definitely the case.
And what's so disturbing about this is you carry the baby to term, you're waiting to deliver, and then all of a sudden you have a car accident from a drunk driver, you know, something that you had no control over, and it took the life of Brady. I just can't even imagine what you're feeling and what your family's feeling with this type of loss. In terms of the drunk driver, did any charges get pressed against him? Is he... You know, was he sorry and remorseful? What happened?
He was an actual repeat offender. Several DUIs. And he did accept a plea after about 6 or 8 months. And then a week before he was to be sentenced, he committed suicide.
The reason this story is so tragic is because in some states, an unborn child, Brady in this case, when his life was lost, there was no fetal homicide law. And so there's just so much, I think, guilt associated with this. There's so many tragedies. And if I may ask you to humanize Brady, you brought a picture of him. Will you share it with everyone?
Yeah. He was 8 pounds, 2 ounces. Brady saved my life, is what the doctors told me. If I wasn't pregnant, I wouldn't be here.
So he is truly my angel?
He truly is.
And Heather has taken this tragedy and she's trying to spin it into some sort of a positive to get the law changed, correct?
Right. After I was okay and able to go home, you know, I had to plan a funeral for a baby that I never got to meet. I had to tear down the nursery. And I want to be an advocate for other pregnant mothers so they don't have to go through what I went through.
And you're still fighting.
If
you're
I
fighting
don't fight,
to change,
nobody will.
To change the law in your state of Colorado. And joining us right now from Colorado is State Senator Owen Hill, where Senator Hill's fighting to change the law. There currently is not a fetal homicide law. And Owen, why is this so important?
Well, thank you for having me on. You know, hearing Heather's story, you know, I'm in tears. And every time I hear it, I'm reminded, as a father of four, that life is one of the most precious gifts we're given. And when you hear this tragedy and then recognize there hasn't been justice, you know, as a lawmaker, I look at that and say, there's a loophole here preventing justice from being had, preventing Brady from getting justice. And so we have a strong moral duty to close this loophole and make sure there's fair and equal protection under the law.
So you are fighting along with Heather. How do things look in regard to changing the law in Colorado?
Well, I'll tell you, I never could possibly live up to what Heather has done to put a face and a story on this tragic instance. And yet, 38 other states have fetal homicide protections, and Colorado doesn't. And to me, again, that's a failing of our state here in Colorado. So obviously we'll always be optimistic, and we'll keep fighting. This, again, is our moral duty for not just for our kids and for our grandkids, but every single one of us. If we expect to have justice, we can't let such an injustice go by.
So I'm assuming if this law were on the books, then the gentleman, as a drunk driver who had the car accident, he would have been prosecuted for murder then, basically. Is that correct, if this law does come to be?
Right. It means Brady was going to have the exact same protections that anyone else who got killed by a drunk driver would have. It's, you know, it's absolutely unconscionable that, you know, that this little 8-pound boy, you know, I remember when my daughters were born, the smallest one was 6 pounds, 9 ounces, right? This little boy would have less justice than one of my daughters would. That's absolutely a failure of our legal system.
Well, Owen, thank you for sharing your perspective with us. And as I mentioned before, there are just so many tragedies here. And sometimes law itself, even people who may be guilty of something of this nature, I think that there is a guilt associated with that. And I do think that there should be fetal homicide laws, because like you said, Dr. Ashton, Brady was viable. Brady was ready to live his life, and his life was cut way too short. We're just so glad that you shared him with us, and we know how hard this has been for you. And of course, those of you out there watching, if you are in a state where you don't have fetal homicide laws, you can do like Heather's doing and champion this cause. Heather and Terry, thank you for being here with us.
We really appreciate it.